behind me here, it's the Vintage Harvest. So it looks like a lot of caterpillars with steel tracks pulling red and green machines. chaff in the front. He's got chaff on the front of his machine. bundle again. I have no idea what this is. McCormick? I have to go to the back and find out with you guys. This is a McCormick International, made by International Harvest in Chicago, Illinois. All these drag pull behinds got American flags on them. I'm not sure if they're all made in America or what. Probably. So again, this one's got spreaders in the back. It's all chain driven though, nothing hydraulic. The bulk tank up there, clean grain coming up the side. And this counterweight. This counterweight's to make it easier to lift and raise the head, I assume. That's height control. This one's a little more advanced. It's got tin metal head or metal reel with metal fingers. This thing is a piece of history right here, you guys. I can't explain how old this looks. I'm sure it's picking it up in the video. So this one's got its own motor on it right here. Look at this. The frame is wooden. Got that wooden frame, wooden drawbar. It's metal reinforced, but that's wooden. Just a lot of physical spinning CV axles. Here's his tractor, Caterpillar D4. Who knows how old it is? Old. Again, that's Jim's tractor. Here we go. It says Diamond. Looks like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, a straight six. Got the controls up here, the wooden driver's seat, very comfy, very nice. At least this one's staying nice and oiled, you know? The chaff's sticking all the oil. I don't know what's up there. Here's the oiler. Old number 51. Then we got this one. Alice Chalmers. Not Almas Chalmers. Alice Chalmers tractor. My buddies in the UK might like this one. Got a sticker for the event. That's where we are. It's got an M on it. Again, clean grain on the side. Engine on the front. Oh, there he goes. I need to get that guy. We're gonna run over there and get that guy once I'm done. Rumally, Creighton Gulkey. A lot more metal parts on this one than you'd think. It's a wooden reel though, there's not even fingers on it. Just a wooden reel. The belt's made out of canvas. Motor driven. Some of it's ground driven. I'm not sure what. Well, it looks like they might drop some power from that. Maybe not. I don't know. Look at this. Wood parts. This is what you don't see on the old new combines. A lot of wooden parts. Gotten away from that. Go over to this tractor. Maybe this is the one Jim was driving. I don't remember. He's driving one of the silver ones. Another Caterpillar, not seeing a number on it. So it's got hydraulics. Go up here and down over here. I'm not sure what the hydraulics run on this. There's a greaser. Maybe this is how they start the engine. Very possible you crank it to start it right here. Fire extinguisher, that's important. Engine temp gauge, oil pressure gauge. American flag in the wind. Pretty long auger on this one compared to the other ones. This one's actually pretty big. Maybe this one's Jim's. I don't know. This one's a John Deere number 36. Is it a B? Possibly. At this part of the video, I would have already seen them in action. This is letting you get a better look at what they actually are. Again, with the cantilevered weights. More wooden parts. Like, this is wood. Does it have a wood frame? Doesn't look like it. Here's your steps up to your operator area. Oh, maybe this one's automatic. Yeah, this one's automatic. You don't gotta be up on this one. I don't think anybody has to stand on this one when it rides. Maybe there's an umbrella up there. Here we go. Now we're getting down to the rear one. John Deere 36B. This is a rare combine. I was told it's a hillside machine. I don't see the hillside mechanism on them though. This might not be a hillside machine. Rubber? That's pretty fancy. Clean grain starts a lot higher on this one. The whole threshing area is just higher up. So this is your clean grain here. Clean grain goes up, dumps in the bulk tank. It's a short auger though. No wooden parts on that one. This one again with a wooden reel. This thing is so rusty. How's it going?
Good.
This sounds the wrong side. This one's got a wooden reel too, canvas belt. 1948. Number 51, McCormick Deering Company. Museum owns this. That's a 1930 something international. I already forgot what series. TD40. Operator control is a wooden seat with carpet wrapped around it. It's really fancy. Another wooden reel.
Canvas.
We have a hole in it. Working on a hole in it. Cantilevered weights. Those look like those are about ready to fall off. Lots of mechanical belts. This is a case something, we're about to find out. Rubber, these are rubber. .49 case V2. Well, they're cutting over there. The 36B. D6. There we go. Caterpillar D6. Diesel, it says. That one just started. That'd have been fun. See if I can start this one. Get a crank start.
I saw you. Know it all. Yeah, I would have. Yeah, I forgot. Problem is, you gotta kick it out of gear.
Hard to start it by hand in gear.
Oh, decompression.
Yeah, decompression.